Knowing what we know now, would you have authorized the invasion?
I would have, and so would have Hillary Clinton, just to remind everybody, and so would have almost everybody that was confronted with the intelligence they got. In retrospect, the intelligence that everybody saw, that the world saw, not just the United States, was faulty. And in retrospect, once we invaded and took out Saddam Hussein, we didn't focus on security first.
All right, by now we all know that by heart. Did he misunderstand the question? I just think it's obvious he misunderstood the question, but that doesn't change the fact that he wasn't prepared for that question going forward. Joining us now is James Taranto, columnist for the Wall Street Journal, editor of opinionjournal.com. James, you wrote a great piece about this, Jeb's rookie mistake. First, let's address that question. Do you agree that he probably heard her say, if you knew then what you knew then, would you have voted to go to war then, as opposed to if we knew now what we know now? Because he referenced Hillary and the other people almost immediately.
Well, he didn't answer the question that she asked. Whether he heard the question that she asked is another story, is another question.
Right.
I don't know. What makes me a little bit reluctant to simply accept that explanation is that he stumbled over answering the question several times after that, before finally coming up with a reasonably sensible answer.
Well, right, which begs the question, how on earth? I mean, as George W. Bush's brother, the main thing that they're going to hit you on, whether it's Megyn Kelly or anybody else, is, you know, what do you think of the Iraq war? Would you have gone in? Was your brother right? Blah, blah. How do you overcome this problem? I mean, the question could be asked a million zillion different ways. How could he not have had every one of those ways covered before he starts doing interviews and putting himself out there?
Yeah, well, that's a rhetorical question. It seems from the answer that you played that what he was prepared to do was highlight Mrs. Clinton's vote for the war, which, of course, is a very legitimate point. I believe she's the only person currently running for president who voted in favor of the war. And but the problem is she has actually said, contrary to what he said, that if she had it to do over again, she wouldn't. So by framing it in this way, he has changed her disadvantage into an advantage, at least if you accept his first answer to the question. Now, I think, you know, one can question the premise of the question. Obviously, we're never presented with perfect knowledge of the future. If we were, we would never make mistakes. So it's a somewhat ridiculous hypothetical. But on the other hand, that also makes it easy. You say, no, of course, knowing what I know today, knowing everything that's happened, not only during the Bush presidency, but during the Obama presidency, and knowing what Iraq looks like today, of course not. And then you can go on to make whatever more specific points you want to make.
Yeah, well, again, you know, we had someone on yesterday who said that obviously those like Ted Cruz and others who were saying, of course not, are not familiar with the documents that were recovered. And it's basically, I blame the Bush administration, the George W. Bush administration, for never defending after the fact why we went in. And here we found this, we found that. I mean, there were old chemical weapons. There were documents found that said he planned to reconstitute his chemical weapons program, his WMD program. So if we had left him alone, that might have been the case. There were some Al-Qaeda people present. So there was a case to be made, which has never been made. But with that as the backdrop, I think there was a wing of the party that's military people that are really unhappy with saying, oh, it was a terrible mistake, we never should have gone in. They view it as being disrespectful to the people who made sacrifices to go in.
Well, but again, remember how the question was asked. Knowing what we know now, would you go in? Knowing what we know now, when you think about everything we know now about the state of Iraq and the world now, you put it all together and you were given a choice between what is a certain catastrophe and an uncertain outcome. Given a choice between those two outcomes, the answer is easy. No. Knowing what we know now, we wouldn't have gone on. It's just that it's an absurd premise. And, you know, one way of responding to the question would have been to say, well, knowing what we know now, I would have done this, that, and the other thing differently after going in.
Right.
But if you just accept the question that was asked at face value, the only reasonable answer is no.
Right. All right. What about George Stephanopoulos? See, today he said he was sorry. He should have revealed that he made the contributions. He was just trying to help sick kids and fight AIDS, et cetera. But, you know, when he grilled Peter Schweitzer, he said, you worked for George W. Bush. You take money from the Koch brothers, knowing all along that he gave, you know, $75,000 to the Clinton administration, the Clinton Foundation, which he was defending during that interview.
Yeah, well, look, I am prepared to take Stephanopoulos's word for it that his motives here were charitable. And, of course, there's no reason to think that it violated any of ABC's formal rules. The problem really is for Stephanopoulos and for ABC that he has now become part of the story, that even as a charitable, as a well-intentioned contributor to the Clinton Foundation and somebody with these longstanding ties to the Clintons, he has an interest in furthering the idea that the Clinton Foundation is completely on the up and up. And the fact that he didn't seem to violate any formal rules in doing this is sort of a synecdoche for the whole Clinton scandal, which is they appear to have been using the foundation as a legal way of evading campaign finance laws.
Yeah, well, you're absolutely right. But I guess Stephanopoulos could have come on and say there is absolutely no evidence to suggest. Go ahead, I can't find any evidence to suggest that I did anything wrong because I didn't break any rules or violate ABC's rules. So you're absolutely right. But it does raise red flags. James, always good to talk to you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
James Taranto, ladies and gentlemen. And when we come back, we're going to talk about this and everything else you could imagine. It's on a little thing we like to call the Malzberg panel, and it's Friday. So it's the Friday Malzberg panel, which is usually the best because it's Friday. So don't go away.